Hi, I'm Jay from Wood Finishes Direct. In this video, I'm going to be highlighting the key things you should consider before starting your project with the Osmo Polyx Oil Range. First off, what is it? Osmo Polyx Oil is the original hard wax oil, a combination of natural oils and waxes for use on almost any interior project. Hard wax oil is almost as hard as a varnish, but it's easier to repair. All you need is a rag, apply the oil over the affected areas without having to remove any previous finish. Let me show you a very simple test called the water test. All you need is a drop of water, apply a drop to the wood and leave for 30 seconds. Easy, right? If the water beads, then you know there's an existing finish on there. If the water sinks in, this would indicate that there is an untreated surface, so you can move straight on to application. It's always a great idea to start with the best canvas possible. Sand your wood through the grits up to P120. This is a fine sand on bare timber in preparation for finishing, not suitable for removing varnish or paint. Always sand with the grain of the wood to avoid scratch marks. What's the deal with clear? A clear product suggests that it doesn't change the colour of the wood, but it actually does. Clear Polyx Oil will bring up the natural tone and patina of the wood, enhancing the grain. It will appear darker and what we call the wet look. If this isn't for you, then we recommend the Osmo Polyx Oil 3044 Raw. This will lessen the wet look on lighter timbers such as oak and pine. Raw gets mixed results on hardwoods, especially darker hardwoods, as it contains white pigment. If you're looking to change the colour of your wood, then you can go across to the Osmo Polyx Oil tints, which come in a range of colours. The whole Polyx Oil range comes in handy 5ml sachets to do your test areas before buying a bigger tin. Over application isn't uncommon with Polyx Oil, but is avoidable using the pass method. Prepare properly. Sand the wood to P120. Apply thinly, always working with the grain. Remove excess using a microfiber cloth. Sand lightly, abrade the surface with a finishing pad once dry. End coat, apply and leave to dry. Nice and easy. Without following the pass method, over application issues you may face are a sticky feeling surface, longer drying time, a patchy finish and product pooling on the surface. The last thing to consider is sheen. Sheen refers to the amount of light the finish reflects from the surface. Contrary to popular belief, this does not have any influence over the durability. Matte gives you a flat, matte look and feel. Semi-matte, a slight sheen added to the wood for those who don't want dead matte. Satin, the halfway house between matte and gloss. Gloss gives the light a good surface to reflect off. Do you need further technical assistance or advice on your project? Why not put us to the test and give us a call? Links to all the products used in this video are in the description on YouTube. We hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe for future content.